Welcome to How I Built My Fundraising Consultancy, the stories behind the people driving results in the nonprofit sector.
I started the Domain Group when Tim Burgess, my original business partner at Domain, he and I found a partner that had an ongoing business and merged with him. And that's how we got that business started, which is another way people, you know, listening to this podcast, if you contemplate starting a business and you don't have cash, you might team up with somebody that shares your interests. So that's how we did that. The cost was basically making a future commitment to that party as relates to their share value. So we eventually bought that person out. That's how we, quote, financed it, or how we started it.
Hi there. Welcome to How I Built My Fundraising Consultancy. I'm Tim Chatton, Marketing Solutionist at MarketSmart.
Today on the show is Richard Perry, co-founder of the Veritus Group. Richard has been running the Veritus Group since 2005 and prior ran the Domain Group for 15 years, which also helped nonprofits. In today's interview, Richard shares from his wealth of knowledge helping nonprofits for over 25 years now. You can find more information about the Veritus Group at www.veritusgroup.com. Here's my interview with Richard.
I'm here today with Richard Perry of the Veritus Group. Welcome, Richard.
Well, thanks. Good to be with you.
Glad to have you on the show. So I was looking a bit into your background. It looks like the Veritus Group's been running for about 12 years now.
That's correct.
Is that right?
Yep.
Yeah. 2005. And then prior to that, you ran the Domain Group. What was the Domain Group? What was that all
about?
The
Domain Group was a full-service direct marketing agency based in Seattle, actually, with offices in Colorado and Atlanta and London and Paris. And we were, at that time, one of the largest direct marketing firms serving nonprofits in the United States. And we worked as well with nonprofits in Canada and in France and UK.
Okay, so you shifted from helping to market nonprofits to working with them on the fundraising side of things.
No, we were doing fundraising back then, too.
So you were,
direct
okay.
Marketing was all the online, not online, I mean, we did online, but television, radio, direct mail. So it's all the direct marketing side of fundraising for a nonprofit.
Okay, yeah, I see. Now, did you take any of the people from the Domain Group in starting Veritus, or is it a whole new set of people?
No, we sold Domain Group, my business partner and I sold Domain Group in 2005, and the acquiring company did not want to continue with the major gift work. I was managing all those companies with Domain, and the technical work I did was major gifts, and they did not want to continue with that because they were a direct marketing firm as well, whereas major gifts is one-to-one kind of personal contact work. So I just continued on my own, and then I brought Jeff Schreifels in, who was an employee of ours at Domain. So he is a former Domain employee, and we have some other people that worked at Domain as well that work with us now.
Okay. And I was looking through the website of Veritus Group, and it looks like kind of your objective is to help nonprofits treat their donors as partners instead of just an ATM.
Yep.
Has this always been the focus and objective of the group, or has it shifted over the years?
No, that's always been the objective. I've had a long-standing conviction, Tim, that donors need to be treated as partners versus sources of cash. And one of the problems in fundraising and nonprofits in general is that donors are treated as sources of cash, which is why they are essentially not treated properly, and then why they go away and why a donor attrition is so high. In fact, in the commercial world, customer retention is 94%. In the nonprofit world, it hovers between 41-50%, and it's a direct byproduct of not treating the donor properly or valuing them.
It's remarkable how often someone will give to a nonprofit, and before the nonprofit actually thanks them, they're asking them again for more money.
Well, yeah, that, and they're not telling the donor properly that their gift made a difference, which is why they go away.
Yeah. When you were starting Veritus Group back in 2005, how did you do the branding, the coming up with the name and all of that?
Well, Veritus, that word comes from two words, verit, which is the Latin derivative of truth, and us, which is community. So truth in community. And we feel strongly about that telling the truth and being authentic is an important thing that we need to have in terms of our operating philosophy, both in the business as well as with clients and with donors. So that's the origin of that name. The tagline is building authentic donor relationships, which is what we're trying to do in Major Gifts.
Okay. As far as the logo, creating the logo and that side of branding, do you work with somebody on that, or what kind of design elements were you looking for?
Yeah, my business partner, Jeff Schreifels, actually led that agenda. We used an outside party. You know, actually, I don't remember who they were. It was basically trying to focus on the word Veritus and on the concept of building transparency and authenticity into the in relationships, all relationships.
Mm-hmm. Getting a client started, has that process changed over the past many years, or has it been the same since 2005? What's your process like for getting someone up and running?
First, we do analysis of the donor file, which we are very much a data-driven company, like we were in the direct marketing field. Anyone that knows direct marketing knows it's all about measuring cause and effect. You're trying to measure what the response rates were, what the average gifts were, what the sources were, et cetera. And we brought that over into major gifts, which is actually a new concept in the major gift field. So we always start with analysis. What are the donors doing? And invariably, we find that what they're doing is that they're going away. They're either going away, which is donor attrition, or the value from the same donors is going down, which is value attrition. We start that way, and then we build from that into developing the client and the donors and the major gift officers.
Okay. Has the tools you've used changed in the past 12 years? Has technology changed for doing the research?
Yeah, technology has, with the advent of social media and growing use of social media and on email, all the electronic forms of communication, as well as just information available on donors, both wealth information, asset information, and social information, has changed the landscape in terms of how major gift officers manage a qualified caseload of donors. Still doing the same things. It's just enhanced. It's sort of like information on steroids with all the electronic media and social media.
So you'll be looking into their social media accounts and seeing engagement and promotion of that nonprofit to see just how attached they are to that organization?
There's some of that that goes on, but it's mostly about finding out information about the donor and who they are and what the match is of their passions and interests to the needs of the organizations, because that's the key link that has to happen.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. Your schedule, what's that like running this very successful consultancy? What's your day-to-day like?
Well, I spend most of my day, if I'm not traveling or off with clients, which I do a lot, I travel probably at least on average once a week somewhere. Spend most of my time either on a video conference call, a phone call, or just sitting at my desk doing reports and emails and that kind of thing. And there's a combination of time with clients as well as time with our people and our management team.
Okay. And did you find success quickly with Veritus Group, or did it take a while for the company to grow and become profitable?
It's been profitable all the way along, primarily because we had already started at the Domain Group a service for major gifts. And it's that part of the business that just kept going, which I was leading. That's an advantage right there.
Yeah, clearly. Yeah, you had a good foundation.
But I started the Domain Group when Tim Burgess, my original business partner at Domain, he and I found a partner that had an ongoing business and merged with him. And that's how we got that business started, which is another way people, you know, listening to this podcast, if you contemplate starting a business and you don't have cash, you might team up with somebody that shares your interests. So that's how we did that. The cost was basically making a future commitment to that party as relates to their share value. So we eventually bought that person out. That's how we, quote, financed it, or how we started it.
Oh, okay. Veritus is currently a team of about 9 people. Is that right?
Now it's up to about 12.
12. Okay.
And it's a virtual company. It's not bricks and mortar. I have a strong conviction about that as well. Bricks and mortar wastes a lot of money. You have to rent and you have to do all of these things. And so we're all independent contractors.
Okay. I should ask, how quickly did you grow to the team of 12? Was it just you and your partner at the beginning?
Well, it was just me at first. And then about 2 or 3 years later, Jeff came on. And well, it was me and another party. So it's taken this time to grow it to where it is now. We're not that big of an organization, but we have created a fairly significant footprint in the major gift sector of philanthropy.
And do you have any assistance, or is everyone kind of self-sustained and gets their own job done?
Everyone basically does their own support work. Although we have in the sales area, we have analysis that's done out of Dallas, whereas the sales function happens out of Philadelphia. I manage the business affairs of the organization, and I'm in Florida, but the finances and operations is managed out of Lexington, Kentucky. So we've set that all up. I'm the architect of the way that works.
Okay. I've looked and I've seen that you guys have helped more than 72 organizations. What's been the biggest challenge you've had to overcome for a nonprofit?
Well, we're working in the major gift section, which is the high net worth, high capacity people that give a great deal of the money to most of the nonprofits. The biggest hurdle has been to convince a nonprofit to let us, the Veritus Group, manage their major gift officers. Because after we do the analysis, like for instance, we had one client, a very large client out west, that we were showing that in a period of 2 years, they had lost their existing donors. So we're talking about value attrition. Their existing donors had lost $148 million. So they become convinced that that's a true loss. Now the question is, how do we manage the 25 to 35 major gift officers to actually make them more productive and start dealing with that loss? And that's usually a difficult thing to do, primarily because there's some folks in nonprofits that believe they actually do that work, quote, sales management work, adequately, when in fact they don't. So having an outsider come in and do it is sort of a new concept. We can do it better and cheaper. So that's the part that we have to convince them on.
Okay. Have you found a certain industry or vertical that Veritus has been most successful with?
Well, that's an interesting question, Jim. We haven't. We've been successful in many of them, major universities, healthcare, social services, some faith-based organizations. So I can't actually discern that we've been more successful in one or the other.
Yeah.
The university and healthcare systems are more oriented to a concept called annual giving, which basically we believe is a wrong concept because it basically has the people inside think of the donor as annual givers versus continuing givers. So that's been a paradigm shift that we've had to help those people adjust to. We've seen success in all of those various sectors and verticals.
Okay. Looking over your website, I noticed discipline is something you point out as being a core component of Veritus. What does that mean for your company and how is that executed to have your clients' work be that much better?
If you look at a nonprofit and you were to analyze their donors, no matter how large or small they are, there's a hierarchy of donor value there. And the 80-20 rule really applies. 20% of the donors are delivering 80% of the value. The discipline and focus part has to do with focusing on those 20% and especially on the ones that we are losing or that they are losing to either recapture them or reduce the amount of attrition that's going on. And that takes focus and discipline. Now, the reason it's very hard for many nonprofits and people in nonprofits to focus and have discipline in this area is because there's always some other prospect out there that can do better than the donors that they already have, or so they think. So you have authority figures directing major gift officers and folks to just go out and try to find those people that are going to deliver the $2 or $3 million gift or the $5 million gift, and they get off of the donors that they already have. And that's a serious, serious problem.
Okay.
So discipline is very important. Stay focused, stay disciplined.
Don't go towards the shiny thing once
exactly.
You see it. Yeah.
Yep.
What's the Major Gift Academy online training that I saw mentioned on your website?
That is a really cool course that basically takes all the disciplines and all the topics of major gifts and puts it into an 8-module, 8-week course for major gift officers. And then there's also a version for leaders and executives as well. You can get 36 CFRE credits. It's basically an educational thing that you sign up for and go through and get certified in major gifts. Very, very comprehensive. There's nothing like it in the market, really.
Is that something you'll send nonprofits you're working with through their gift officers so they have the right train of thought as they're working with you?
Yes. And there's hundreds of major gift officers even that aren't clients that have already attended that. Now, there's a cost to that, but they sign up and it's just kind of like going to school, basically.
Okay. What book would you recommend to those getting started?
I was thinking about that, and I've read, you know, all management, well, not all of them, but a bunch of management books and some of the things that people talk about in terms of relationship, and I could not come up with one. What I did come up with an answer to that question is to pursue any book or literature that deals with management by objectives, because that kind of thinking, which comes out of Peter Drucker's thoughts back in terms of management, that you manage by objectives. There's another school of thought out there that's basically the balanced scorecard. So balanced scorecard and management by objectives are two management principles that if you balance both of those and learn about them, that'll take you somewhere that I think is going to be very important.
Okay. For finding new clients, how do you do that? Is it word of mouth at this point?
Well, we write a blog, we speak a lot at conferences, and we do referrals. So those are the three sources of people get to know who we are. And from that, we offer our analysis, which we do for free, the donor analysis, which is our sales way of getting to the very core problem we're trying to solve, namely donor attrition. That's the primary way we get business.
Okay. And that's been the same since 2005?
Yeah, you have to show the, and this is true in any business, you have to show what the problem is that you're solving by through your product or service. That's what you're offering in exchange for a fee for services.
And if you were starting fresh, say it's 2005, but you have all the knowledge you have today in 2017, is there anything you'd change about your first couple of years of operation?
No, I wouldn't. We would do the exact same things. It worked then and it's working now. We've improved on it. We've gotten better at it, but we're still dealing with the same problem and still applying the same solution.
Okay. Did you have any mentors, or do you have any mentors that help kind of guide you in directions for the consultancy or otherwise?
I didn't. I was thinking about that question when you sent the questions to me in terms of what we were going to talk about. And this is going to sound funny, but the best mentor I had was way back in grade school, a teacher who told me to think outside the box, to not be afraid of taking a risk, and to approach things with optimism. And failure was basically a pathway towards success. So that imprinted on me and has been a very helpful thing in the development of my career and the several businesses that I've started.
Okay. And you've been running businesses for now 27 years. What was your life like prior to ownership?
Well, way back, I was actually a DJ in a country and western station. But then I worked in publishing, but I was mostly a director of development and major gift person. And so that's kind of where I started.
So you'd worked within some nonprofits prior to starting up?
Yes, okay. So I have real world experience. And in fact, the person that started the domain group with me, Tim Burgess, he and I worked together in a nonprofit. And the reason we started the domain group is because we were so successful at the work we did in the nonprofit in terms of donor acquisition. We took film crews all around the world and developed hour-long television specials and short-form television specials and short-form radio programs for donor acquisition and set up telephone centers. And so we were very, very successful at all of that, which then prompted us to say, well, why don't we start this business and pass on the formulas and the success that we've learned, which is how we did that.
Okay. Can you speak a little bit about the structure of the business?
So there's two business partners now, Jeff Schreifels and myself, and we brought in a top person that deals with client services and then working with clients. So that's that part. Underneath the client services are client managers who manage groups of clients, essentially. So that's that whole client service side. On the business side, we have sales, which is anchored by business partner Jeff Schreifels. And then working underneath that is the whole analysis function for donor files. And also the website, the blogs, all the social media initiatives that we have, that also comes out under Jeff. And then I manage the business side and have finance and operations, legal and all of that, contracts, pricing, business planning, budgets, that kind of thing.
Okay.
So those are the three big categories. It's rather traditional.
Yeah. And do you do any outsourcing for copywriting?
No, we do that all internally.
Okay.
Both Jeff and I are writers, so we write a lot of our own stuff, actually.
Okay. Do you have a favorite text editor, or do you just work in Microsoft Word, or what's your favorite tool for writing?
Yeah, I just use Microsoft Word. That's the biggie.
Okay. Yeah, pretty simple. Do you have any other tools that you use on a regular basis that you like to work in to get your job done?
Well, we use PowerPoint, and we've been getting into Prezi as well in terms of presentations. Excel is a favorite. I don't need to develop spreadsheets and forecasts and do the analysis and sort donors into hierarchies of value and capacity and all that. So Excel is a big one. So all of those Microsoft Office products are really helpful to us in all aspects of our work: sales, management, client management, analysis.
When we return a quick lightning round with Richard, first quick break, we will learn about a webinar Jeff of the Veritus Group did for us here at MarketSmart. You've heard Richard talk about Jeff Schreifels, senior partner at the Veritus Group. Well, Jeff partnered up with us here at MarketSmart and hosted a webinar entitled How to Think About Major Gifts So You'll Get More of Them, which you can access at www.imarketsmart.com/howtothink. In this presentation, Jeff covers how to think strategically about soliciting major gifts so that they can add up to a larger percentage of your organization's annual donations. This presentation includes real-world examples, comprehensive research, and actionable ideas that you can implement to raise more money right now. You'll learn how to think strategically about generating more major gifts, the seven pillars of a successful major gift program, i.e. how to tier your caseloads, create goals, and much more. You'll also learn the steps required to build a predictable, repeatable system for success with major gifts. You can access the recording of this webinar by visiting www.imarketsmart.com/how-to-think. That's imarketsmart.com/how-to-think. With that, let's get to the lightning round with Richard.
What's the best piece of business advice you've ever received?
To measure cause and effect. That's the advice I'd hand out on your next question to a 25. If I was a 25-year-old and someone was to give me advice, I'd say that too. Decide where you're going. Always measure what cause gets you to that result and then adjust, measuring cause and effect. In other words, are your activities purposeful?
And do you have a favorite personal productivity habit?
I'm always prioritizing. Analysis of the work I did in the last week or last month, and where did it get me? And was that useful work? And did it get me to the objective? So analyzing priorities. One of the big, big traps for all of us as human beings is activity, non-purposeful activity. And that's the stuff you have to be constantly on to get rid of. So that's what I'm doing most of the time.
Okay. What's the best under $100 purchase you've made in the last month or so?
The microphone that I'm currently speaking on, because we do a lot of podcasts and webinars, which is a Yeti microphone.
Yeah, Blue makes wonderful microphones. Yeah. It's a great microphone. Yeah.
That would be one. And then some internet connectivity type products, but I can't remember what their names are, but that would be about it.
Okay. Do you have any favorite monthly services or subscriptions you're signed up for?
Not formally. I mean, I do like the news service Flipboard, where you can actually program what you're getting and what you're feeding. And so I use that a lot to give myself information on various types of topics and categories.
What's an interesting or fun fact about you that most people don't know?
That I'm a practical joker and I just get a big kick out of humor, because people don't know that because I'm so objective oriented and so serious and focused and type A that they might not know that little part of me.
Yeah. Now, you do a lot of writing. Do you have a favorite word?
Yeah, my favorite word is options. Options in business. And that doesn't mean that I'm not a committed person and a loyal person, because I am. I'm not thinking of options when I'm in a relationship, either business or personal. But that's my favorite business word. Always be thinking of what your options are in case something fails.
Mm-hmm. Desk or car, what would you clean first?
Be my desk. That's where I work.
And do you have a favorite kind of animal?
Yep, my dog.
Tea or coffee?
Coffee.
What do clients never ask you that you wish they did?
They don't ever ask me, why do I do what I do? There's an assumption there that I'm in this just to make the money. Well, not really. A primary driver for me is meaning. To help nonprofits develop resources to do good on the planet is a very important thing for me, and that's the main why.
What are the best nonprofits doing right?
Well, the best ones are measuring cause and effect, and the worst ones aren't. If you actually think about it, Tim, even in a personal lives or professional lives, there's a whole lot of stuff we're doing that just does not matter. And it's driven by personal preference or personal need. I've got to do this. This makes me feel good. I love doing that. But it has nothing to do with an objective.
Yeah, there's many paths to accomplish the same thing.
Yep, exactly. Some of the errors are not measuring that. Like, why are you involved in that activity? Oh, because of this. And is it getting you where you want to go? No, it's not. Well, then let's get rid of it. That's what they're not doing.
Mm-hmm. What charities do you admire or support?
Again, I support a whole lot of them. I like all of our clients, so you can go to our website and look those up.
Yeah, naturally, all the clients. Where can people find more information about your services?
You can go to veritusgroup.com. That's spelled with a U, V-E-R-I-T-U-S, veritusgroup.com for our services. And then for the Major Gift Academy, majorgiftacademy.com if you want to explore that.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Richard, for your time today. It's been wonderful chatting with you.
Thanks, Tim.
Thanks for listening to this episode of How I Built My Fundraising Consultancy, presented by MarketSmart. If you like the show, make sure to review it on iTunes and pass along to a friend or colleague. If you're curious about what we do, make sure to check out imarketsmart.com. And don't forget to check out Jeff Schreifel's webinar by visiting www.imarketsmart.com/how-to-think. Thanks for listening.